Hi, my name is Shiv Simani. The reason I did 24 workouts in 24 hours is because I've always had a vision for Kenya and for Africa and the world in general to be a much healthier place. I've seen what fitness has done for me, and I see what it has done for other people, and I know what it can do for many other people. So I knew I had to go big to make an impact. So what I did is I decided to work out for 24 hours to create awareness for the need for people to make the time to work out and get active and do something for themselves to help prevent or reduce the risk of chronic lifestyle diseases such as diabetes, hypertension, high blood pressure. And I strongly believe in exercise as medicine. So this is how I thought that I would be able to pass this message across to as many people as possible.
Yeah, so I thought I'd do something that's outrageous, slightly crazy, you may say, a little bit insane, but I felt like this was how the message would be passed across. And from what I got, I feel like I achieved what I wanted to achieve. I got to inspire people, I got to get people moving, I got to get people thinking more about their health and their wellness in general.
All right, so let's talk about preparation for this event. Wow, I think I decided to finally do this probably 2 months to the day. And actually no, I had thought about something to do probably like 6 months before, but the idea was way different from what I thought about. So it evolved and finally came to this 24 hours in 24 workouts in 24 hours. Now, to prepare for this, I just, you know, looked at YouTube, looked at a couple of people who've done some amazing feats of fitness, who've like run ultra marathons, who've worked out for 24 hours. There's other people who've actually done this. So I was like, okay, these people who are crazy enough to do this and who've done it in a more intense way, so I can definitely do this. I can probably do this. So training wise, there's really no manual for this. So I came up with my own training program. I was like, okay, this is a lot of endurance work, a bit of strength, a bit of stamina. So what am I going to do? I'm going to just work out as much as I can every single day, whether it's three times a day, once a day, as anytime I have time, I'm going to just get a workout in. And I'm not going to discriminate workouts. I'm going to do as many workouts as I can. I'm going to do some strength, I'm going to do some conditioning, I'm going to do some endurance, so I'm going to swim, I'm going to run, I'm going to do some bodybuilding. All right, so during this process of coming up with my workout plan, my meal plan and everything, I was also experimenting on my body. So I also decided to go vegetarian. It was for health reasons, to experiment, because I watched a documentary. You've probably heard of Game Changers, you've probably heard of What the Health and other documentaries. So I was like, look, I'm not just going to take their word for it, I'm going to actually experiment on myself. So I went vegetarian, I was off alcohol, I was sleeping as much as I can, also to rest and recover from all this working out. So I was basically doing everything I possibly can to be as fit as I can. And I think 2-3 weeks into my training, I was starting to feel absolutely amazing. And I was just going better and better and better. I remember having doubts of whether I could do it, but the one thing you don't want to do is start to doubt yourself even before you've started the workout, yeah? So it was always, yes, I can do this, yes, I can do this. I decided to get that mindset of, this is just any other workout, so I'm going to do this and it can be done. It has been done before. All right, so let's just skip over to the day of, or the day before. I prepared, I packed all my stuff, my camera gear, my food, my everything basically, clothes, slept early. I wasn't able to sleep immediately. I think it probably took me an hour to sleep, which is very rare. I usually like knock out in like 5 minutes, 10 minutes, but my mind was just buzzing. I woke up later than usual though. I think I woke up like 2 hours later, which is like 6 a.m. But I was feeling good, I was feeling fresh, I was feeling healthy, I was feeling strong. Packed everything, took my bags, ran a few errands, came to the gym early, and I was going to start at like the workout at 5 p.m. So by 3 p.m. I think, by 2 p.m. I was already at the gym, and I had one huge meal, absolutely huge meal, so that by 5 p.m. I was ready to go. Yeah, so 5 p.m. I've set up all the cameras, I've set up what I need, and I had people coming in. I had guests every hour on the hour who are going to come with me, and we were going to record as much as we can on Instagram Live, on Instagram Stories, on Instagram, talk about our experience during the workout and why we work out. Yeah, so that's what the guests were for. The guests were mostly celebrities, social media influencers, clients, friends who are into the lifestyle. So I wanted them to come on board to give their perspective on fitness and why they work out to other people. Hopefully someone will be able to inspire someone else, because maybe how I pass messages across or how I pass a message across might not resonate with someone else. So maybe someone else coming on board who's in maybe their kind of situation would have a better effect on them. So that was the reason for inviting other people. So the first workout, the first few hours actually were amazing. I think the first workout we went hard, we went a bit too hard actually. And I think by like halfway through the workout, I was like, oh no, I need to like slow this pace down. But then again, I was excited, so we killed that workout. Second workout came quickly, killed it. I think the first three workouts were just a blur. They passed by really quick. I was being smart about this. I was like, okay, I'm trying to pass a message across, but I'm also trying to protect my body. So in my programming for the 24 hours, I also had, I think, four sessions where it was more recovery. So it was long stretch sessions and mobility, just to get my body, so my body just doesn't seize and, you know, just feels too off. So after every 4 or 5 hours, I had a stretch session, which I think really helped me during the 24 hours. Also in terms of eating, I was eating a lot of fruits, a lot of bananas, that is. I was eating a lot of berries, antioxidants, food rich in antioxidants. I was eating a lot of fats, that's nuts. I was eating and drinking a lot of water. I was drinking, I think, 500 ml every hour for the full 24 hours. I think I ended up drinking around 12 liters of water in the 24 hours, which was crazy, but I didn't feel like it was a lot because I kept sipping. I was trying to avoid cramp. I was trying to avoid fatigue. I was just cheating my body. Yeah. So I had guests coming over, I think up till around midnight from 5 p.m. It was like go, 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 go. Guests were amazing. I was really feeding off everyone's energy, from over 25 to Gabby to Mandy to my boy Dylan to Gingerbread Man, my clients Omar, so many people. I don't even know. If I don't mention you, I'll mention you at the end. Your picture is there. But yes, there were so many people coming in by that time, and I was feeding off everyone's energy. I love that everyone came in with such good energy, and I fed off that. I think from now 12, from midnight, I felt the first, like I felt like now my body started to go downhill and it started to get tough. I was absolutely tired in terms of my mental state, and what was really tiring was the fact that I had to keep stopping. Like after a workout, you finish the workout and now your body starts cooling down. You go into social media, you talk about it, and now you have 15 minutes before your next workout. So what do you do in this 15 minutes, you know? All right, you're on social media, but now your body cools down. And at the top of every hour, I had to start the next workout. So now getting into the right mental state to start the workout again was difficult. That, I think, was one of the hardest things in the 24-hour workout. Getting your mind right, your mindset right to start a new workout, getting your body awake was a bit tough. So what I also did to help me with this was I came up with the same warm-up. So I had the exact same warm-up from hour 1 to hour 24. This now eliminated the process of me thinking of what do I do to warm up, what do I do. I'd already tried and tested it, and I knew this warm-up would get me going quickly and get my mindset. So my mind, as soon as I start doing this warm-up, even if I'm just going through the motions, you know, my body is just going through the motions, it kind of sends a signal to your brain telling you it's time to go, it's time to go. So that's kind of the hack I was using to get ready for, you know, the next workout and stuff. By this time I'd already changed outfits like twice. Yeah, then now that early morning from like midnight to 6 a.m. oh man, this there were some fun hours where I had Bryant come in, I had Walter come in, and we just did workouts, man. This time we tried to do some really hard workout. It seemed hard at the time, but we did it another time and we absolutely killed it. We were very slow, we were very sluggish. Like, this is when our bodies were saying you should be asleep. And at this hours, I absolutely appreciated having someone with me, because they were one of the toughest hours. Yeah. Then Calligraph came in and we killed it. We killed the workout with him and his crew and Pippen and his boys. And before you know it, it was 6 a.m. I think when I started to see the sun come out, it's like your mind switches again. And I started to get a high. I started to feel amazing again, like I've just woken up, which was absolutely weird and amazing. And just, it's something, I don't know how to explain it. It's like I got a high again from the workouts. So 6 a.m., 7 a.m., 8 a.m., guys came in with so much energy and we were buzzing, you know, it was fun, it was amazing. But I think 10, 11, that was now like the worst down I've had. I think there's a workout I actually didn't finish. I think it was like 11 or 12. I didn't finish the workout. I felt like I was about to collapse, like I was done in my mind. That's the first time my mind actually said, you're done and that's it. Before, it was my body which was feeling weird, but my mind was still like, was okay. But this time my mind actually like almost convinced me that you're done and that's it for you. But you know, I think I sat down by myself in like a closed room for like 10 minutes and I was just like, no, this that's not it. We are not done. We're going back out and we're going to crush it. Yeah. And I think in that moment it was such a revelation, like the power of the mind. You can really will yourself to do almost anything. I think anything, let me just say anything you want to do if you get in the right mindset. That's one of the biggest takeaways I got from that, by that hour. And now the last half from like hour, let me say from like hour from 1 p.m. I had till the last workout was going to be at, was it 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. or 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. Anyway, I'm not even sure now. But one, I think, was a chilled out workout, but the workouts after that from like 2, 3, 4 p.m., I think my last four workouts, I felt the best I've ever felt in workouts for that whole month. And it was the best I've felt in workouts for that 24 hours. And that was like a testament. That was, it was an out of body experience. Like, I get into a workout and I just move and I'm just going. I think part of it was this adrenaline, this rushes, because I know I've gone through 20 hours, I only have 4 hours to go, nothing's going to stop me. So it was just go, go, go. I was crushing it. And I wasn't thinking about like the end, I was just thinking about what I have to do at the time, the rep I have to do at the time. Before you know it, the workout is done. We've gone on Instagram, we've talked about it, you know, we've high-fived, and before you know it, next workout is in. And those last few hours, I had so many people come in, and the energy was so good. I like recreating that scenario, and that energy is so tough in any circumstance, but it was amazing, and it was so supportive, and I absolutely appreciate everyone who came in, like, feeding off them, them coming to support me. And I think every single person I invited to come for this and more, and so many more came, that meant a lot. No one disappointed, no one, not like I was going to be disappointed in any way, but I understand people have things to do, you know, but everyone came through, which was amazing. And it also showed me that how much the togetherness people have, we have as, whether it's trainers, friends, and just people in this industry, and how much we want other people to experience what we experience and what we get from working out and from living this lifestyle. It showed me that people are into it and into sharing this with the world. And that was a real motivation and inspiration to me. Now down to the last hour, the last workout, we started slow. Well, guys started hard, I started a bit slow. I think it started with an 800 meter run. First, for this workout, there was a ton of people, and what I did is I left it free in terms of programming. So what I was going to do with it is I was going to let people pick workouts one by one, individuals, like everyone came up and just gave me a workout they want, and I put everything there because I was not trying to be biased, because I felt like I was feeling good. So I was like, let's just do what everyone wants to do. Everyone who's here deserves to do something they enjoy doing. So we threw that into a workout. I think it started with an 800 meter run, and I started so slow. I was like extremely slow, but halfway through the 800 meter run, when it was like 400, something just clicked in me and I just started running. I was no longer jogging and now I was moving. So we ran out the gym. I came back in first and I went straight into the next workout nonstop. I went straight into the next workout. I didn't stop. I think I finished the workout probably a bit earlier, like maybe 2-4 minutes earlier than everyone else, and it was a bit of a shocker. But what shocked me even the most is immediately after the workout, obviously I was happy, it was the last workout, I was done. But what I didn't foresee is the waterworks. Like, my eyes, is I couldn't hold it in. I was absolutely overwhelmed at that point. And during the last workout, I saw my dad walk in halfway through. Chico was there, Shazi was there. I forgot to mention, even my mom and my sister came at 12 at midnight. They were there from like 10 p.m. the previous night to I think 1 a.m. So that meant a lot. But now to see my dad, Chico, Shazi come in for the last workout, I think that just pushed me and wielded me. This gave me so much more energy to push. And at the end of the workout, I remember walking towards Chico, and I couldn't hold myself. Like, it's an experience. I've never been this overwhelmed to the point of crying. So I just walked and I just felt my eyes open up, and I was so embarrassed. So I like went to the back to like cry. I was like I was trying to catch my breath, like wiping tears and stuff. Then I came out like trying to be all tough, but my eyes were probably bloodshot red at that point. By that point, everyone had finished working out, and it was amazing feeling. There was hugs all around, high fives all around, and it was great. I felt like we had done something amazing. We had done something great for the fitness industry in Kenya, for people, and the message was passed across how I wanted it, we wanted it to be passed across. And yeah, man, that was 24 hours. After that, I know my body shut down. I could not walk. Chico drove home. I think I blacked out in the car. I got home, I ate, I blacked out again. I was in and out of sleep till 8 a.m. the next day. And that was it, man. That was my experience. I know I've cut it, like, it's probably cut short, but in a nutshell, that was 24 hours of working out. Would I do it again? I do not know, but I probably would if I had to. So yeah, make the time, guys. That's the message. That's the important message from all this. Just make the time for yourself, make the time to work out, make the time for your health. It will better your lifestyle, it will increase the quality of life that you're living, it will help you be more active and more in the moment with those who mean the most to you. And yeah, help yourself to help others.